Ladies and gentlemen, I have realized that foreign investors who were investing into India, they were having one problem. Then once they invest into India, sometime their money and they want to recover and the borrower has not paid the money. It was a very long litigation process by which they were frustrated. And this was basically a very negative point for them to invest into India. But Modi ji was interested in bringing investment in India, promoting investment under the banner of Make in India. Hence, the new enactment, which is the IBC and NCLT code, IBC code and NCLT provisions have been brought in. Now you need not worry, because previously if the money is some borrower is not paying the money, what will happen? You will go to the recovery court where you will put a heavy amount of fees and a long litigations traveling from lower court to the Supreme Court, and years are years. That is a frustrating and that was a negative impact. Now I am repeating, now what is NCLT provision and IBC code is there, so the provisions are much faster, sure and certain, and of course the time bound also. This is a time bound relief. So you should be happy that your money will, if somebody borrower is not returning money, you can recover it faster by through this passive process. I will throw one line more. Previously, because we must compare, previously you have to go to the recovery court, civil courts, or you have to go to the DRT if he's an individual person and the financial institutions have given the loan and borrower is not returning. Now, if it is a operational creditor or it is a financial creditor, which are the banks, and there is another person who has taken the money, is a company that is a corporate debtor, then you can go to the NCLT and the provisions are very fast. So Mr. Rahul Gupta will like to throw light the provisions. I think this is his forte, that he will little bit more explore in brief points why the NCLT provisions are good. Rahul, please, you can explain, otherwise I can explain, but you are dealing much more than me, so please explain.
It's my pleasure, sir. NCLT evolves by the Introduction of Companies Act 2013 and finally constituted by the order of the Supreme Court in 2016. And the main function for which the NCLT was evolved is for two matters. One is the insolvency and bankruptcy matters, and second one is for the winding up of the company. By the introduction of insolvency and bankruptcy, which is in short I will say IBC, provide an easy exit to the investors in case there is a erosion of the invested amount. What happened earlier is, if an investor invests in India for any innovation, for any business, and they just had an entry, there is no exit point, easy exit point was not available to them. With the help of the IBC, they provide an easy exit in case the money was not misused by any promoter or any third person who is connected with the company. IBC provide a good mechanism under which an investor can have an easy exit within a period of 1 year. I repeat, it is a within a period of 1 year, which usually take before era of IBC of more than 5 years. So investors are looking for to enter any country with the investment, do some innovations with the help of the human resources available with the country, and if they succeed, definitely it will provide employment and taxes for the country. And in case there is any change in policy in the government of India and any government, then there might be a chance of 1%, 2% the company goes with the erosion of the value of the assets in which they invested. So IBC, with the help of NCLT, helped the investor to provide them a ray of hope that if they enter in the country with the investment, then they can have an easy exit also.
Mr. Rahul, may I a little bit more clarify and ask a question?
Yeah.
That means you want to divide in two parts. One is the IBC part, second is an NCLT part. Both are almost same, but the difference is, when IBC, if any money has been taken by a borrower, by a corporate debtor, then the first effort by the mechanism by which the financial institution is proposed a solution by the resolution professional. So you mean to say this is divided into parts. First they try to somehow resolve the issue
right
by this process.
Right.
If it is not resolved, then the NCLT legal process come for auction and all that. Right. So you have thrown light on the first part, second part you will cover. Please, you will explain
that. Yeah. As sir is rightly said, that the IBC provide a mechanism in which the investor will have to go through a process which is well defined in the IBC code 2016, and after passing through the process, if not any other investor is looking for the investment in the company, then the company will go into auction, into liquidation by the order of the NCLT. Then auction process will start and the property of the assets, property of the company will start selling one by one. The IBC here, the main preamble of the IBC here is to restructure the borrowings in such a way that new investor will able to run the company, to protect employment also, to generate more taxes for the country and to run the business.
May I interrupt here for a minute?
Yeah, please.
That means the effort, the first effort is to, you know, if some corporate debtor is there, you don't go or winding up straight away. You
yes.
just want that he should the revive, because there is a workman, there is employees who are all are working.
Yes.
The government effort is to smooth solution.
Right.
That you propose to the financial institution that this is our proposal. How can you revive the company instead of closing it? How we revive? And the workers will also continue and the company will also revive. So first effort in IBC is
revive
to put a proposal to revive. That's what you are talking
yeah,
about.
Yes.
If it is failed, then naturally there is no option except going for an auction, and you auction the company, then second part you will tell that, right? I'm just clarifying so that my people who are hearing may be clear about certain point, that it is only an effort to for a smooth running of the same organization, and to instead of kicking out of the corporate data, why not to do the things peacefully, quietly, and in everybody's interest, and in the country's interest also.
Right.
That is the reason I am taking up this matter in a foundation, so that we provide solutions to the people and they feel worry less coming here, investing here. Please carry on.
Right. Sir is rightly said that by the introduction of insolvency and bankruptcy code in India, the position of India enhanced worldwide, and they jumped from somewhere in 150 position to 63rd position all over the world, just because now the India is also a country which is providing an easy exit. They are not just keeping the investor in their litigation process, and then say you are supposed to hire a invest in a litigation just to prove that the money was not misused. Now, if the process, the company is in such a dilemma that there is no other investors reviving the corporate debtor, and then the company will go into the auction. Then in the auction, there is a professional who is appointed by the court, and in the court where the professional is appointed, they again run a process for the auction of the property of the company. And the main motto here again is the maximization of the assets, of the value of the asset of the corporate debtor, so that the money of the lender is returned back to the hands of the lender, and it is again circulated with the other companies and other ventures of the country, and which will definitely helping the country India at a macro level. The lending process, the lending confidence of the banker and financial institution is improving day by day.
So Mr. Rahul, you mean to say at the end that once IBC procedure for settlement fails, then there are some RP professionals, resolution professionals, which are the basically chartered accountants, and there is a firm which have been given a license, only they can depute, and this deputation is fixed by the National Company Law Tribunal.
Right.
Then they appointed the man of the company, that licensed company, and that RP tries to first to propose. If it is fails, then the auction proposals are offered and taken, and then if the auctions are the highest bidder is accepted, then that is auctioned.
Right, sir.
Right. That what you are trailing.
Right.
And there is a time limit of which need not be go too much legal, but there is a time limit for all this process in the beginning, in IPC code for settlement and all those, we need not explain that. Explain, I think you very rightly said.
There's only one liner I must say, that in the earlier era, the investor usually on average, they need to spend more than 5 years to have an exit, to have a reputed exit. But now in the IBC mechanism, the investor is successfully, averagely able to have an easy exit within a period of 1 year.
So ladies and gentlemen, now I would like to conclude it that it is now very safe to invest into India. Because previous, you will not have any kind of worries and about safety of your recovery of your money, which you had in the beginning. Because beginning, for any money recovery, either you will go to the civil courts or you will go to the high court for winding up petitions. So the powers were distributed like BIFR. I need not go in much of the legal depth, BIFR and all those things. Now every company related powers have been vested in the IBC and NCLT, basically an NCLT. So you are relieved, you will get within a limit. If your proposal is not accepted, if your money is invested here and you want to take your money back, time bound, sure certain program, please be safe and happy that you can invest into India. Provisions are much faster. Thanks to Mr. Modi for bringing all these provisions and India flag taking high. Thank you very much. Thank you. Namaste.
Thank you, sir. Namaste.